Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So on today's video, I'm going to be doing a New Year's Eve look for you guys. Something fun, something different. I didn't want to do like red or neutrals. I kind of wanted to do like more smoky, more like vampy, just because I feel like I've been doing that for the last 2 videos that I did, so I wanted to do something different for you guys. So I wish you guys nothing but the best in this new year that we have. Not to be like new year, new me shit, but more like take this year to kind of find yourself and make yourself happy before you make anybody happy. You know, we all go through a lot, we're all human beings, and we all have to go through ups and downs to understand why we are here in this world, to make yourself a better person or just to find yourself as a person. So I wish you guys nothing but love and positive vibes for this new year. So I hope that you guys like this video, and I'll see you guys in 2018. Bye. Hey guys, so I did do my brows and foundation off camera, so I'm starting with my eyes. So I'm using the MAC NC35 Studio Finish Concealer. Sorry, my phone just went off while I'm talking and doing a voiceover. So I'm using a Morphe brush just to kind of, you know, fill in the concealer before I start using eyeshadow. I haven't used this MAC concealer in a very long time, so yeah. Okay, I don't know what I was looking at when I turned my face that way, but I'm using my MAC bronzer in Gimme Sun. This is like my go-to product for 2017. I use this bronzer all the freaking time. Like, I'm obsessed with it. And I also use it in my eyes just to apply neutral colors before I do any smoky eyes or just anything with my eyes. I always go and use this for bronzer or for my eyes. And I'm just using a Morphe brush. So what I'm using in the corner of my eyes is from Juvia's Place. I think this palette is called the Masquerade Mini by Juvia's, and I'm using the color Ada. It's like a very rusty orangey color. It's like, I love neutrals, especially in Juvia's Place palettes. Their pigmentation for the shadows are amazing, and they're not chalky at all. Or like, they really are very pigmented. I really love this brand. This is like, I found out about this brand this year, so far so good. I am obsessed with them, and I kind of use them like every day on my lids, not gonna lie. So the next thing that I'm using is I'm using a very small brush, and I'm putting Too Faced glitter glue just because I'm applying glitter to my eyes and I want like a smoky look going on for this look that I'm doing. So the next thing that I'm using is going to be just like any black eyeshadow, just because I want like a pop when it comes to the shadow that I'm going to put on top of this black shadow. I just want it to really stand out, and I feel like when you apply black shadow or like any dark tones before you put a shadow on top, it's tends to really like stand out and make the eyes pop a little bit more. So that is the reason why I'm applying black shadow in my lid right now. So the next thing I'm going to be doing is applying the shadow on top of the black shadow that I put on. And this brand is called Radiant Liquid Eyeshadow by Nika K. And then the name of that liquid eyeshadow is called Early Bronzy. It's like a very bronzy, brownish tone to it. So I am applying it in my lid, and yes, I have to like let it dry for a little bit, but it really makes the eyes stand out. I bought these in so many colors, and they're so nice on, and they really stand out. So after I'm done with that, I'm going to go back with the black shadow and just kind of put them in my inner corner, just because I kind of want, I'm not going to do a wing. I just kind of want this to kind of like made the illusion that that's the wing, or like part of the wing that I'm creating. And I'm just going to focus it literally in my inner corners. And I'm going to go back with a bigger brush and blend everything out just to make it more neat and put together. So the next one that I'm using is going to be my LA Girl Pro Concealer in HD High Definition in the color Creamy Beige. I really love these concealers, and they only cost me like, I think, like $3 or $4. And like the fact that you get so much product too, which even like makes it better. I bought a bunch of these in like different colors, and like you could like also use them to contour with darker colors. Like, it's so affordable, you guys should really try this out. And I'm gonna see if I actually do a video with cream contour this year, because I know a few of you asked me and I haven't done one, so that's going to be one of the things I'm going to do in this new year for you guys. So the next thing that I'm doing is I'm going to set my eyes with the Laura Mercier translucent powder. Literally, this is like my ride or die, because it makes sure that my eyes will increase throughout the day, especially when I'm at work. This is my holy grail setting powder for underneath my eyes. If you guys haven't tried it, please do. You won't regret it. So after I'm done with setting my eyes, I'm going to set my face and use my powder from Smashbox. This is really good if you have oily or combination skin, just because it sets the makeup and it really keeps you matte throughout the day. So the next thing that I'm doing is I'm putting these lashes on. So I'm trying out this new brand of lashes called J Lash, and they're amazing because of like how fluffy and how like mint their lashes are. And I'm using the style Serena for this look. Obsessed. Like, and you not only do I get to use this once, but I get to use them multiple times, which I love, like reusing lashes that I like. Like, look how beautiful they are. So and then the next thing I'm going to be doing is putting eyeshadow on the bottom of my lash line, just because I want it to stand out. And I'm going back with that black shadow that I was using for Morphe, just to kind of like make my eyes pop out and to make it a little bit more dramatic to the look. So that's why I am applying black shadow underneath my lash line for you guys to see. Every time that I do use or that I put anything underneath my lash line, I use a small brush, just because if you apply it with a fluffier brush, it tends just to get everywhere and it doesn't really like stand out like that. So that's why I use a smaller brush, just to kind of get underneath my lash line and make things stand out and make them a little more dramatic. And after I am done with that, I didn't do it in camera, but I went and put some mascara underneath my lash line, and then I'm going to contour. And of course I'm using the bronzer Give Me Sun Like Always. So the next product that I'm using is one of my favorite highlighters, like my favorite highlighter ever, and it's by Estee Lauder and Heatwave. I feel like this highlighter is like a holy grail product. Like, I use this every year, and I don't use it every day, but I use it in like special occasions when I go out or when I just wanna like make my makeup stand out. I just feel like this highlighter is everything, and every time that I get my hands on it, I know it's a limited highlighter, but I'm obsessed with it, and you guys should really try and get your hands on it. Maybe Estee Lauder will come out with it one more time, who knows. So yeah, I don't know what I was doing. I guess I was having too much fun listening to music, especially listening to Maluma. But I decided to put mascara again on my lashes and on my bottom lashes. I feel like they weren't really standing out, so that's why I decided to put a little bit more, as you guys could see. So after I am done putting mascara on, I'm gonna go and use lip liner and lipstick before I finish this video. So the lipstick that I'm using, well, lipstick, lip liner that I'm using is by MAC in Cork. It's like a brown tone lipstick to make my lips stand out and to kind of make them look a little bit bigger. So after I am done using this lip liner, I'm going to be using the Kat Von D Look Lipstick and the color Crucifix. It's more of like a brown tone, and I didn't want to do anything, like I was saying in the beginning of my video, nothing too bright. Kind of wanted to do a bumpy look for you guys to see. So this is it, guys. I hope that you guys enjoy this video, and I will see you guys next year, and I hope that you guys have an amazing year, and love you guys. Thank you all for all your support. Love you guys. Bye.
Against me, I'm a girl with a temper and heat. I know I can get crazy, but I'm not just a sucker. I'm the fuck up you need. I don't hear nobody when you focus on me. Perfectly imperfect, yeah, I hope that you see. Tell me you see, 'cause I know that you've been thinking about it. Shut up.